Piercing Light is the highest damaging sniper rifle in the game. It has a decent base critical hit rate and a low base critical hit damage. I use Piercing Light for Colossus boss fights, invasions, strategic outpost missions, and special operations. This is my go-to weapon whenever I want a boss to go down fast. For the build, I only have one build since there is really not a lot of ways to build this weapon, and also there is a big issue with heavy weapons. Heavy weapons are suffering from bullet crisis because the developers refuse to buff or improve the acquisition of heavy weapons reserve ammo. But despite the bullet crisis, we do have Glay and Enzo who have abilities that can manipulate weapon ammo, so don't forget to subscribe so you guys won't miss my Glay and Enzo build in the future. Let's start with the weapon readjustment options. Go for firearm critical hit rate, weak point damage, firearm attack, and firearm critical hit damage. You can also replace weak point damage with bonus firearm attack versus Colossus. Before we proceed, I'm using Enzo with a transcendent module supply firearm enhancer, which increases weak point damage by 15%, and it also increases firearm critical hit rate by 29%. I'm using Enzo for the test to make all the shots consistent. For the modules, let's start with Action and Reaction and Rifling Reinforcement, increasing firearm attack by 93%. For the Critical Hit Rate modules, I'm using Edging Shot and Better Insight, increasing the critical hit rate by 69%. The base critical hit rate of this weapon is 40%, adding the two modules increases it from 40% to 67%. If we include the weapon readjustment option, it gives a total critical hit rate of 71.84%, which is decent. For the critical hit damage modules, I'm using concentration priority and better concentration, increasing critical hit damage by 71%. The base critical hit damage of this weapon is 1.2 times. Adding the two modules increases it from 1.2 times to 2.053 times. If we include the weapon readjustment option, it gives a total critical hit damage of 2.266 times. I also added weak point sight and weak point detection, increasing weak point damage by 55%. The base weak point is 2 times, adding the two modules increases it from 2 times to 3.1 times. If we include the weapon readjustment option, it will total to 3.328 times. I also added expand weapon charge to increase the total ammo in the magazine from 6 bullets to 8. Now, this is one of those modules that is really annoying since it's only 49%. That 1% actually matters. But since the developers hate heavy weapons and is trying to be annoying, we are now stuck with a 49% rounds per magazine. For the last module, I added an Almandine socket and a Malachite socket. Now, you have three options: weak point expansion, dopaminergic activate, and special sight. Weak point expansion and dopaminergic activate both have a cooldown of 10 seconds. For the weak point expansion, the first damage is 2.7 million, and when the module is on cooldown, the damage is around 1.6 million. For the dopaminergic activate, the first damage is 2.1 million and when the module is on cooldown, the damage is around 1.6 million. Lastly, if you want consistent damage, then you can go for special sight, which increases weak point damage when aiming by plus 30%, but at the same time reduces movement speed when aiming by minus 30%, which is really not that bad. For the damage, it deals 1.8 million damage. Overall, this weapon is pretty decent, and by far, this is the sniper rifle that has the highest base firearm attack in the game. Having a 71% critical hit rate is not that bad, but you need to pair this weapon with a Descendant that has a critical hit rate increase ability like Enzo, Volby, and Healy to make every shot count. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.